Well, Jamie, thanks. It's amazing now, I must think, for you, 12 years after you've been drafted. What stands out the most from that experience for you, that whole draft process?
Well, that's amazing, like you said, 12 years ago. I think more than anything, like you saw probably last night with some of the kids that got drafted, you spend it with your family, all the people that worked so hard to get you, you know, to that level. You really accomplish a dream. So I tuned into the draft. What an honor for some of those kids. And, you know, before you know it, they'll be playing at the stage.
It didn't take you long. When you were drafted in 05, you were back up in Colorado by the summer of 2006. What would your advice be to especially a first-round pick, in terms of everything that's required to get there?
Oh, man. That'll work. I think, you know, what got you to that draft is going to get you to the big leagues. Stay in and day out, trying to be the best player you can be. Don't worry about the expectations that people put on you. You're going to be the player that you're going to be. Well, have no regrets. You know, do everything with purpose and with passion, and things will work out how they're supposed to work out.
10 months after you made your big league debut, Kevin Durant was drafted, then by Seattle. We saw him win a championship last night. How much is the thirst, Troy, for you to lift that trophy, to get that ring that's eluded you in your big league career?
Yeah, that's what it's all about, winning. Nothing else matters. I come to the field every day, try to be a good teammate, and focus on winning. Some days are going to be good, some days are going to be bad, some months are going to be bad, some are going to be good. Try to be as even keel as you possibly can be, which is difficult in this game, especially as a young player. But when you focus on winning, the pressures that this game puts on you at times, it goes away when you focus on winning. So that's advice right there for anybody. Just worry about that and everything else, you know, second.
Do you look at benchmarks, the flipping of the calendar of a month, the fact that the team is hovering around 500? Does that matter to a baseball team? Does that matter to you in terms of, okay, we got to 500, or now that it's this month, what's been accomplished? Are those benchmarks that you look at?
I think how we started, getting to 500 would definitely be something that maybe other people would think we can get there, but us as a clubhouse, we knew that we can definitely get there. So, you know, win a game tonight, get back to 500. Division is right there within reach. We play those guys at the end of the year, you know, day in and day out. So we definitely have our hands full because it is a good division, but the team we have is definitely awesome.
Because of that start, more than ever, are division games real critical now as we get into the meat of the schedule?
I mean, there's so much season left. What is it? 99 games left. So there's so much schedule left. They're definitely meaningful, but at the same time, they're not do or die yet. Can't put that much pressure on yourself. But we do know when we play the AL East, those wins are important. They're not must wins, but we definitely know that they're important.
I appreciate the time as always.
All right.